the fiber optics group in EPFL's School of Engineering has developed the technology to amplify light inside the latest hollow core optical fibers. This new technology can be a promising breakthrough for the future of communications. Today's optical fibers usually have a solid glass core, so there is no air inside. Light can travel along the fibers, but loses half of its intensity after 15 kilometers. It keeps weakening until it can hardly be detected at 300 kilometers. So, to keep the light moving, it has to be amplified at regular intervals. The EPFL's new approach is based on new hollow core optical fibers that are filled with either air or gas. The air means there is less attenuation, so the light can travel over a longer distance. That is a real advantage. But in a thin substance like air, the light is harder to amplify. That is the crux of the problem. Light travels faster when there is less resistance, but at the same time, it is harder to act on. This new discovery has squared that circle. So, what did the researchers do? They just added pressure to the air in the fiber to give some controlled resistance. It works in a similar way to optical tweezers. The air molecules are compressed and form into regularly spaced clusters. This creates a sound wave that increases in amplitude and effectively diffracts the light from a powerful source towards the weakened beam so that it is amplified up to 100,000 times. Their technique therefore makes the light considerably more powerful. This technology can be applied to any type of light, from infrared to ultraviolet and to any gas. Their findings have been published in the journal Nature Photonics. Going forward, the technology could serve other purposes in addition to light amplification. Hollow core or compressed gas optical fibers could, for instance, be used to make extremely accurate thermometers. The researchers say that we will be able to measure temperature distribution at any point along the fiber. So, if a fire starts along a tunnel, we will know exactly where it began based on the increased temperature at a given point. The technology could also be used to create a temporary optical memory by stopping the light in the fiber for a microsecond, that is 10 times longer than is currently possible.